All right, up next we got Mudace and Mr. R currently. I'm putting a tweet out that this is about to be coming up next. And you got King Chris and Black Twins. Black Twins, the king of the random button.
Word.
But been playing Pichu a lot in this game.
Yeah, I have no reference over Black Twins and King Chris, unfortunately. I heard the Black Twins. I saw them playing today. And like you said, I saw them rocking the Pichu.
Both of them coming in from Canada. Uh-huh. I believe King Chris is also from Canada. And then you have Mr. R and Mudace rocking the Crom and the Peach. Yeah, this could be a very dangerous team.
So you got one Femme Fatale, and you got the other one just a frame bully with a sword. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. One that can really put you in these frame trap situations. One that can really like just juggle you and get these hits. But now here we go. We got and we got Peach, who is a heavy hitter herself. Mm-hmm. And we all know Mr. Mudace is Peach dog.
I always wanted to work a job where pretty much I could just do whatever I want and nobody's gonna question anything. I want to work at the developer office who approved all of the frame data from Crom, because nobody seems to glance over the fact that he's got all the boxing tools. Meanwhile, Pichu also got the same thing, just that pressure that Black Twins can put on. Here's the thing, though. Mudace knows the rap matchup pretty damn well.
Yeah, and Pichu is one of these characters where there's only one speed and it's go, because he's the Akuma of this game, and you really have to play him one way, and that's super, super aggressive, because catching this man slipping might mean an early death. But Black Twins fighting Mudace offstage as we speak, but Mudace back in advantage, and ooh, good grab.
King Chris also just getting straight out of dodge. Being over against the ledge against Crom is one thing, but against the ledge against Mr. R, a ledge trap king is another thing, and the good defense on him just to reset, and not really too much interaction going on, because I feel like everybody's trying to get a beat on each other at the moment.
Yeah, and we see them like all just running interference on the ledge and trying to get stage position in the middle. But right now, my man Mr. R with Crom and just putting all the pressure on Pichu right now, and
that 26% answer almost killing Pichu as well. But Black Twins with a good DI now going up, going away, except both of them are going away right now, wrecking on those freaking flyer miles that everybody's getting coming down here, losing them stocks.
Yeah, that good dash attack coming out from Mr. R, sealing those stocks pretty well. But now, oh, you see both of them getting sandwiched, and here we go with the 1v1 situation. This is what we talked about earlier, but King Chris got trying to play off that, got to get the back airs, and an SD coming out from Mr. R.
I don't know if I call that too much of an SD, because there was like a lot of pressure situation coming in from them. He did die, but the whole thing was set up by good follow-ups from King Chris and Black Twins. I definitely like to see more of that synergy. Meanwhile, Mudace just trying to live, just struggling over on the side, trying to get by. The up throw is going to take the stock out, though.
All right, so we got even stocks in between everybody. So fresh stock coming out for Mudace, and Mudace trying to put in just a little bit more work. But King Chris trying to do his best against Mr. R here. Mr. R putting him back, just sitting in the middle of the stage trying to create
like
a wall.
The fact
and
that
that's
King
what
Chris
I was waiting on. Yes,
exactly. Mr. R was lurking so much. Like, yo, go ahead. Stop looking. I'm going to body you. He was just waiting for the fact that Black Twins was trying to go save King Chris, which is exactly what he should be doing, but getting punished hard for it.
Here we go, my man. Black Twins just throwing a little stuff out of neutral. This is a good punish opportunity coming out. And like I said, everybody getting punished. You try to
good
throw somebody.
Good coverage from King Chris, because you saw Mudace standing right in front, ready to get that down tilt to big damage. Not able to get anything else. Meanwhile, Mr. R actually going down to his last stock. And King Chris doing a really good job of keeping himself alive as well.
Here we go. Good up airs. And, you know, he went for the fan kick. He knew that he was going to convert the combo. And Mudace just trying to survive just a little bit longer. And shaking out hits like that. Good fair off that. And just pressure. Good back air combo.
And all of these
out.
All these up Bs for Mr. R are okay because of where Mudace's range is played. He's there just in case he gets a recovery attempt. But the problem is, King Chris didn't have his partner there either, and that backer is that miss grab is going to get a punish, and that's going to lose the stock.
Yeah, now we don't really see like a lot of synergy things happening at the moment. Like, we really just see, like, you know, like, hey, you go in, and if your mix doesn't mix, then I'll just come in and cover you, things like that. And it's working out particularly well for the yellow team right now, especially since Mudace has another stock to give. And like these guys, if these guys just stay separated, they might come out. But King Chris says, look, man, we trying to win too, in a good back air to seal that stock. And here we go. High damage situation for Pichu. And as I say that, Pichu's dead.
I was about to say, no more mistake availability for Mr. R on recovery. But it doesn't matter, though, because he's going to take out Black Twin stock. So now they could both play ledge trap like they're doing right now, covering pretty much every option, including flip kick, which is not what Zero Suit wants. Oh, letting go on the last hit of the side B. Gonna allow him to get by. No follow-up from Mudace, though.
Look, and this is where doubles can get actually very dangerous, just because it's like you already have Peach, who just cuts off your recovery routes.
that defense get back on the ledge the way that King Chris was getting by, and he ain't eat his veggies.
I'm telling you,
he
dog.
He ain't eat his veggies.
When Peach is above that ledge and just drops turnip, it's just like, oh, pick your poison. Do you want your roll cover? Do you want your get-up cover? Do you want your jump cover? It's really, really dangerous.
It's so important in this game to manage jump usage as well as just forcing people in edge guard situations to blow it early. When you can just throw a projectile like that down and continuously get them so fast, it's so stressful. But even though King Chris did a good job of getting off the ledge before, it didn't matter. There was two people staring them down.
Like, that's one of the great mysteries of this game. How do you beat that route? How do you beat that route coming out from Peach? She throws the turn up, and it's just like, What do I do from this? Do I pick how I want to die? Is that really what
it's like? Like, choose your own destiny.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, the destiny was straight to the blast zone. Oh, we're seeing a double switch here. We got Joker and Roy. A lot more boxing now that will be up close and personal between these two, rather than more of the defensive maneuvers they were doing, which worked well. But I think that this is going to be a very good team composition as well against the Peach.
And I feel like Arsene as a thing as well, especially how fast this man is gaining Rebel Guard. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, I feel like Arsene will come in big, big play with these like meaty hits that he can get in doubles.
Yeah, you do one big string on me and now I get to play. Yeah. It's kind of like a heavy matchup. If you're playing as a Bowser or a DDD or something like that, you got to accept you're pretty much starting a 60 against a Peach.
Yeah. Yeah, but after that, you get to play the game. And Arsene is out. The big boys have come to play. So, hey, all Black Twins is waiting on just a simple combo conversion and a forward smash, dying early.
Yeah, King Chris coming in and just smacking him out of existence. That back throw is going to give him stage positioning, and they're not going to opt to go for the 2v1 on Black Twins. Instead, Mudash just kind of holding the ledge, hoping to get the edge guard.
Yeah, and like I said, Joker's going to be one of these dangerous characters, so Black Twins, and really he can hold his own, but those hits like that, forward smashing in neutral, just geez.
I mean, the sweet spot on Roy, or Krom, either way, if you catch somebody sleeping, just catching them running a little bit too quick, you get hit by that, you might die dumb early, and that would be huge for Black Twins.
Right, so we got pretty much high damage stocks for everybody except for Mr. R, who unfortunately lost that start to Joker earlier, and still not dead at 138, and he's close to getting Arsene once again.
And double-edged dance closing out that stock on Mudace. Mudace is doing a good job of holding the stocks. King Chris gonna finally die off the top. Town and City coming in clutch a lot, but not that time.
Here we go. So we got not even stocks, but Roy, the survivability Black Twins, we see you, baby. We see you doing your thing right now, okay? We see some juggles coming out.
Good combo breaker coming in from Black Twins, too, because if Mr. R was able to get the single hit in there, he could have cashed out into an up B. That would have been about 56 to 60% right off the start, and that is not what he wanted. Black Twins doing a good job of holding his stock while being a blitzing character, too, not losing this first one. Never mind. Here comes the Peach Bomber. That's going to take it out.
Yep, commentators, and we're just the kings of speaking way too soon.
they chose their own destiny, but we are the ones who really control the destiny.
Honestly, so here we go. We got Arsene is out, and another stock lost by Mudace. Didn't see how that happened, but looking pretty advantageous right now for the red team.
King
They're
Chris
doing way
digging
better.
In deep and going for him off the corner there. And Mudace, who was holding his stock so well at the start, actually looking at the first low, the actual low stock usage compared to everybody else.
And look at these guys. These guys are just out here mashing A. They're just like, dog, okay, I'll throw my option, and then you throw yours next. And if I shield it, then you shield it. But then I'm going to go, and I'm going to have my partner cover me. Just pure madness coming out from both teams right now. Not even going for combos. They're just going for the smallest possible hit they can get.
And I like the fact, aggressive recovery there from Mr. R, noticing that Black Twins was on the platform, going to try and go down there and get him. He has his jumps available still. Mudace is going to kind of block the path, preventing him from getting edgeguarded.
Here we go. And this is that high-level play that I talked about earlier. We see these guys just walling each other off.
Mm-hmm.
Walling each other off from ledge. Be like, look, we got the ledge. Now it's time for you to make a choice. Here we go. Not going to go for the back air there. Black Twins going for
it. I like the fact that he did it because he just went so high up that if he whiffed, you already saw that Mr. R was ready to run in and get that back air. He would have closed it out. So that was good mental awareness of risk management coming in from Black Twins there.
Oh, and you see he tried to combo off it with the up air. Not going to be able to get here, but Black Twins whoop, didn't get the fair. Unfortunate for Mudace.
Mudace just barely scathing his shoes. That could have been huge. That landing fair, though, is going to take out Mudace's stock. And now Black Twins and King looking like they're going to get themselves on the board.
Here we go. Now you're in a rock and a hard place, my friend. I mean, even if you do get a stock off of Roy, you still got another stock to give. So, hey, it's just a matter of time, really. So
I love watching the way Mr. R just B-reverse cancels his way back to center stage. He's like the best one currently doing it at that, but he got his jump rip on the get up there, that footstool. Don't need to be anything fancy. As long as that stock's gone, we're going right to game three.
So Chris and Black Twins, very, very, very wonderful adaptation by both of those guys. I think the character picks, you know, are very, very crucial, especially in a 2 out of 3 format, especially for the whole tournament, you know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So this is like where you wanted to make the adjustments, and they made the adjustments very well. So I want to see how Mudace and Mr. R adjust to this.
Yeah, you know,
I don't see him switching, though.
I don't think so either. And, you know, outside of Mr. R maybe going with, what, a snake? I don't think he's going to do that in that team composition. And you see a lot of times people will not be confident in their original picks and then lose the next game.
Yeah.
Here's the thing, though. The ability that Black Twins has, being multi-talented character specialist, and we already see that from King Chris too, ended up working out for him. I think now, though, with counterpick advantage, we're going to see a much different pace of play coming in from Mudace and Mr. R.
And here we go. We're going to see it out here right now. We got game 3 happening right now on Final Destination, so no room to run. We all going box.
I like it, as well as the fact that there's nowhere to land and escape, because that was a big thing that Red Team was taking advantage of, getting on the platform and kind of just dodging a lot of the problems. Now, because you have next to no landing, it's all about who has the better up-close footsie game and who has the better mid-range boxing game.
And you saw how, like, literally, like, it was Mudace's number one priority to try to get that Roy as far off stage as possible, mm-hmm. but Black Twins keeping his jump and able to recover the correct way off this. And oh, look at this, just more 1v1s off the side, and
doesn't get the jab to bear there. That could have been it, and he's been just completely all over Black Twins. Meanwhile, Chris all over Mudace on the left hand side.
She died in 68. Arson is so good.
It's so strong, that counter in the back air, everything online. And it's one of the reasons why Peach players have a huge problem with the character, just being able to actually challenge Peach recovery. Not many characters can actually do that.
Here we go, my man. Black Twins and King Chris looking real, real strong right now. King Chris not even in the 100s yet, but this Roy having the biggest difficulty dying right now. Uh-oh, here we go. You see,
you're getting forced off stage yet again. Yeah. See, King Chris putting himself as a wall in the way, so Mudace couldn't go for that ledge trap. Like, all right, you want to get to my boy, you got to go through me first, but he's going to get through to him finally. Black Twins losing his first stock.
Here we go, both these guys, everybody just pretty much scrapping in the middle, and ooh, that was gutsy going for the side B like that.
Another great aggressive landing.
Oh, that was insane!
Doubled it up because of the fact he got aggressive, and then all of a sudden, Black Twins trying to go get him on the ledge, and it worked out for him. That was like a 5 to 10% kill. That's huge for the yellow team right now.
The yellow team, man, they really, really, really needed that, and here we go. Now they have all the momentum in the world to lose, and getting caught by that upbeat like that on ledge, very, very fortunate for them. And now it's giving Mudace a little bit of room to breathe with.
So exactly, and Mr. R, a momentum king. Whenever you give him those opportunities like that, he's, see right there, he has the stocks to play with. So he's going to go off stage. He's going to try and challenge you on that. But he's going to get hard punished on his way back down from the Soaring Slash, and finally getting them off that first stock.
Now, I saw Mudace over here trying to kind of bait King Chris to come out there, but that's a very dangerous game because that man got down guns. And if he happens to hit you with that, then you might die, my friend.
Yeah, you get that jump ripped on you after trying to just establish some pressure. But you know what? It's strong. It's a good thing that Mudace had the confidence to do so. And you have to be very careful right now. King Chris just hopping around with arson everywhere. One of those straight hitboxes is going to delete one of those stocks on Mudace. Meanwhile, Mr. R just trying to establish them into the corner. And finally, there's another stock coming in from Black Twins. Yellow team still holding this lead.
Look at this. Yellow team, 2 stocks apiece. Mudace has no qualms about dying at this point. I'm pretty sure he wants to keep his stock for as long as possible. But now we already see the wall being created by the other team. Already. Ooh,
yeah, see, he was trying to serve him up right into Mr. R there, but just barely missing. Doesn't matter, though, because they're still putting that pressure in the corner. Black Twins doesn't get the roll read to try and force him off stage. They need a double team or something on Mudace, because at 176% with so much kill potential, that character needs to go.
And speaking of potential right here, oh, you are so lucky you died with the Mr. Saturn in hand, because that was another variable that you did not want at this point. My man Joker sitting at 105. Arson needs to come out and play one last time before the stock goes.
Yeah, that would be huge on them. And you see the King Chris trying to go for that ledge guard so bad, but Mudace just kind of staying in his way like they did to them before. That's huge. And now Arsene coming out one more time. Like you said, can he close out a stock on Mr. R to make it worth it?
Wow, and we just saw a level of smash attacks, but nah, that's going to be it for you, fam. Oh, trying to neutral B, trying to tote him off the stage to sail it. But hey, Mr. R with the cleanup, and that is going to be it. A hard-fought game by Black Twins and King Chris, but Mr. R and Muday is pulling through.
And who's to know what would have happened if that that upbeat didn't rip Black Twins off the stage? Because he went with that aggressive recovery with that fair, took out King Chris, trying to get it, and then they took a whole stock away from them. That kind of ripped like a lot of the momentum they had out of their hands.
Yeah, nothing says like best laid plans like somebody accidentally getting their stock taken. So.
Yep.